Dad, I'm sorry. I was feeling sleepy and I need to study, so I was hoping that something would wake me up.
Okay. Study hard then.
Yes, Dad. Good night.
Good night.
Okay. Remember the deal? You do remember the deal, don't you? You and your friend will be our slaves for 1 week. I got tired from driving. How about a back rub?
You bastard! You cheated, that's why we lost!
A deal's a deal! Don't tell me you cowards are chickening out!
We do what you say if you fought fair and square. But no, you guys cheated!
Shut up!
Hey! Daniel! Come on, sir! Let me go! Hey! Stop it, Sam! Get up, Daniel! Get up!
Come on, get up!
Get up! I know why you're doing this! You wanted to get in trouble, so I lose my scholarship! But that won't happen, because you won't get even a single bruise to use as evidence against me. You got that? Huh? I'm never gonna let that happen!
Ma'am, we finally found the woman that you were looking for. We already know where Mira Cordero lives.
Where's Nathaniel? I thought he'd be back soon because he doesn't have classes today.
Maybe he's still hanging out somewhere.
Oh, no, not my son. He's a scholar.
I envy you. You have such a good son. My child gives me nothing but headaches.
It's hard to earn money these days, so I'm really proud of my son's scholarship.
Mother, Aunt Benny?
Hey, what took you so long? Where have you been, son?
After Presto and I finished the project, we played some basketball.
What's that? That's a bruise. How did you get that?
So what's your son's problem?
You know, the boy grew up without a mother. Without anyone to look after him. So no matter what I do, he still becomes rebellious.
Mother, I said I'm fine.
What are you talking about? Your face is all bruised. It's terrible. You had a fight, didn't you?
No, Mother. I just fell when I was playing basketball.
I don't want you lying to me. Tell me the truth, Nathaniel. The truth.
Mother.
Look at yourself. Look. Just look at it. Look. Is that how somebody who fell down would look? You got into a fight. It's obvious.
Ouch.
Admit it. Tell me, who did this to you?
The school president's son.
My God! Why?
I didn't fight back, Mother. I just let him beat me up. I couldn't risk it.
Of course you couldn't, son. They're very influential. Next time, just try to avoid him so you won't get into trouble. My goodness.
Sorry.
Of all the people to pick a fight with, why the president's son?
Nicole, mm-hmm. You're late for school. I have exams today.
Oh, brother, you picked the wrong time to wake me up.
Why?
Good morning, Dad.
Rafael, there's someone I'd like you to meet.
Who, Dad?
The woman whom I feel will become a good mother to you. Fiona, sweetheart?
Yeah? Oh.
Ma'am?
Who does he look like, sis? Brad Pitt? George Clooney? Or Leonardo DiCaprio?
I missed out on that part, brother. Thanks to you.
Okay. Anyway, is he a hunk or a boy next door type?
Brother, didn't I just say I didn't get to see his face? The only thing I'm sure of is that he's my dream boy.
Have you known my father for a long time now?
No. Because if I had, I'm sure I would have known that his son is a student of mine, right?
I'm all set. There. It's good that you have met already. Now you both have an idea what each other's like.
You know, Rafael is a good student.
That's good. Because someday, Rafael will be inheriting everything that I own. That's why as early as now, I'm preparing him for greater responsibilities. So son, just study hard, okay?
Yes, Dad. I'll do my best.
Especially now, that I have someone to look after you.
Promise, Dad. I'll study harder.
Hey, sis. Next time you dream of this guy again, remember his face, okay? So I can draw your dream boy in your computer, okay?
Wow, that sounds great!
Hey, what's this? Don't tell me you're bringing this to school.
I just want to show it to my friends.
Is that so? I'll try it on and see if it looks good on me.
Give me that, brother! Give it back to me!
Let me borrow it for
brother,
a while.
Give it
Come
back.
On, let me just
no,
borrow
it. No, give it back!
Trudis is right. I have to start my life over again. And whoever is buried as Arriana, I'd like to thank her. Everyone thought I had died because of her.
I feel that the medallion will be whole again soon. And when I get it from Mira, I'm going to rule the world!
It's a good thing that in spite of all the unfortunate things happening, you didn't throw the medallion away.
Because I believed in what you said, Mother. That if I get the medallion, we'll be rich beyond our wildest dreams.
Our hard work will finally pay off, Savannah. Because of that medallion, we will have more money than what we have now.
Now that I know where the other half of the medallion is, I'll do whatever it takes to get it. Oh my, are you hurt, sir?
No. We'll bring him to the hospital.
There's no need. I'm all right. Besides, I know that it was my fault. I crossed the street because didn't notice the car passing by.
Here, please
are
take
sure
this.
Okay?
I'm really sorry.
Oh, thank you, my dear. Thank you.
What's wrong?
You know, my dear, that medallion there, that special thing you got will give you good dreams. You just wait. A good dream will come your way very soon.
I don't believe it. Somebody's been tending to your grave.
Brother, do you think what he said was true?
I really don't know, sis. You know, let me borrow this. I'll wear it first and see if it's effective or not.
Timothy, give me back my medallion. I wouldn't want my dream boy falling for you instead.
No,
let me
no
have
way.
It. Brother, give it back.
Let me just borrow
hey,
it.
Hey, cut it
Come
out.
On.
I'll take Rafael with me to school so he can go straight to work, okay?
Okay, I'll see you later then.
Mm-hmm.
Fiona, I leave my son to you. Don't let him out of your sight.
I'll take care of it, okay?
Okay.
Bye. Rafael, your father's really worried about your studies.
Ma'am, how do I do the exams?
The results aren't in yet, but I want you to know that just because your father and I are seeing each other doesn't mean I'd be changing your grades. So you still have to do good in your studies, okay? But don't worry. If you want to go out and have fun, I won't tell him. Just promise me that your grades won't suffer. Deal?
Mm-hmm.
I should have known it's Abel.
Sir Abel asked me to take care of this grave. I clean it every day, and he wants it filled with fresh flowers all the time.
Looks like he's trying to make up for all the sins he's done.
But it's too late, Terry.
Excuse me for asking, but how are you related to the one buried here? And who are you?
Does Nathaniel's mother really work there?
Yeah, look. They're listed on the yellow pages.
Let me know your name so if Sir Abel drops by, I can tell him that you visited.
She's the sister. Her name's Anya.
It's like this, darling. If you would just say yes, then we can help each other out. You'll have even more money.
Gabby, you're so persistent. You're lucky I'm in a good mood today. Otherwise, I would have sent you out already. Ow!
So, Mira, my love, when will you say yes?
Don't count on it, because I don't plan on getting married. Not until I find my other son. Besides, it's enough that I have one man in this house, Nathaniel.
I know an investigator. I'm sure he can help you look for your other son. He's pretty good.
Nathaniel! Nathaniel! Look!
Woohoo!
What, was that good enough, Nathaniel? You think I can be a clown?
You guys need more practice.
You think so? I was wondering if your mother could teach me. I heard clowns do lots of tricks. What can your mother do? Eat shards of glass? Live chicken? Or hang herself upside down?
My mother doesn't work in a circus.
Well, she sure looks like she does.
Insult me for all I care, but don't you dare make fun of my mother's work.
On the contrary, I think your mother hit big time. Don't clowns know a lot of tricks? What about your mother? I also heard they pick pockets for a living. Tends to vanish into thin air. Tell me, how much was your mother able to steal to buy you the Jeep?
You bastard! My mother's not a thief! Hey! Nathaniel! It's enough! Hey! Where are you going? Stop that!
Hey! You! Get out of here!
It's good that you came to visit your sister's grave. By the way, your mother, Miss Milagros, has something for you.
Where is she?
I don't know, but she told me that if you'd ever visit here, that I give you these letters that she wrote for you.
When did you last see my mother?
It's been a long while, miss. I think it's been around 5 years since she came to visit your father's grave.
And why should I apologize to him?
Of course. You were the one who hit him first.
He deserved it. And he deserved more than that. I should have beaten his face some more.
Nathaniel, is that what you've been doing in school, huh? Getting people beaten up? I thought you were better than that. But no. Apologize to him in front of his father.
I won't.
If you don't do that, you'll get suspended. And you might lose your scholarship.
That's okay. All those times he insulted me, I ignored him, but yesterday he went too far. So no matter what happens, I don't care. I will never apologize to him.
So, how's Rafael doing in school?
He's okay. We had lecture this morning and he did good in recitation.
Fiona, I hope you'd be the one to give guidance to Rafael. Since he doesn't have a mother, he might be drawn to the wrong crowd without me knowing.
Jaime. Is that the reason why you courted me? So someone could take care of your son?
No. Of course not.
Because if that's the case, it would be really unfair to me.
Sir, I'm apologizing on behalf of my son. Please forgive him for what he did.
Madam, take a look at what he did to my son. Because of that, I'm seriously considering to take away his scholarship this coming semester.
Please don't, sir. It's his only chance to continue his studies. If you want me to beg on my knees, I will. But please, please, I beg you, sir, please don't take away my son's scholarship. Please, sir.
Mother, what are you doing?
Nathaniel, apologize to them.
No. If there's anyone who should apologize, it should be him, because he insulted our dignity.
Nathaniel, do you even know what can happen to you?
They'll take away my scholarship, fine. Do it, I don't care. But they can never take away my dignity as a person.
What did you want me to do? Argue with them? Curse them because of all the damage you caused?
You didn't have to go there. You lost your self-respect.
How can you say that to me after what you've done?
We didn't do anything to them, Mother.
Yes, you did, Nathaniel. Because you beat up the son of the person who sent you to school.
He's not the one sending me to school. Fine, so I'm a scholar. But I worked hard for it. And they don't have the right to look down on us just because I'm studying there for free.
You failed me, Nathaniel.
That's what you always say. I'm always a failure. I do everything, Mother, and you won't let me into your heart. And why? Because all you really care about is Daniel.
You don't have any right to be jealous of your brother who, for God's sakes, is not even here.
Yes. Let's say it was my fault. Yes, it was my fault. I left him. I left him, but it was an accident. Since then, you've never been able to forgive me.
I never blamed you for it, Nathaniel.
Not in words, no. But that isn't how you make me feel. I'm right here, Mother. But you never see me. Mother, you never hear me. Your whole world revolves around Daniel.
That's not true. I've been slaving all these years just for you. Do you think it's easy for me to work day and night just to feed you? No!
If I wasn't a scholar, could you still send me to school? No! Because you spent all your money just looking for your son.
I thought you'd understand why after all these years I never gave up on Daniel. It's so painful to lose a child.
It's painful for me, too. I lost a brother, too. And when he disappeared, I lost my mother as well. If only I could turn back time. I wish I was the one who got lost, instead of being here with you. Because I don't feel like I have a mother.
Nathaniel, where are you going? Nathaniel? Mira, aren't you going to stop your son?
Let him go. He knows how to leave. He should learn how to come back.
My dearest Mira, I know that we parted ways with ill feelings against each other. But in spite of it all, I remain a mother who longs to be with her children. Your father and Arriana are gone. And you're the only family I have left. I hope this letter reaches you, so that you will know what has become of me. I was forced to leave with Lucio. There was nothing I could do. And there was nowhere else for me to go, since I didn't even know where to find you. I've accepted my fate, and that was to serve Lucio as his wife. Maybe this is the only way to pay for my sin towards him. Because of that, you and Arriana had to suffer greatly under Lucio's hands. But now, Lucio is completely powerless. I wish you will get to visit me someday. I will wait for that day when we can be together again and forgive each other. In spite of everything, your mother still loves Mira very much.
But she never came back. During those 20 long years, even just once, she never came back. She has completely forgotten about mother and father. How can she be so cruel?
Okay, I'll see you in a bit. Hi, Rafael. Your daddy and I bought you something to eat. This is fried chicken and pancit canton. This is your favorite, right? Go ahead, it's really good. By the way, I told your dad that you're doing really, really well in school. So, don't let me down, okay? I know you can do it, Rafael. Right?
Aren't you even going to look for your son? What if something happens to him out there?
He's old enough.
So it's okay to let him wander off in the streets?
Stop it, Venny. You're not making it easier for me, you know.
In that case, then why aren't you doing anything? Start looking for your son. The problem is all you ever think about is Daniel. You've forgotten about Nathaniel. Maybe now that Nathaniel is gone, you can think about him too.
How long are you going to keep this up? Are you sure of what you're doing, Nathaniel?
Oh. It's getting late, sweetheart. You better take me home now, okay?
Fiona. You're a good woman. And I know that you will be a good wife and mother to Rafael. Fiona. Will you marry me?
Oh. Thanks, honey. You know, I missed you. It's been a while since you last visited me.
There was a lot of work to be done. I had to lie low for a while, especially since my wife's becoming suspicious.
When is your wife going to leave us alone anyway?
Let's not talk about her. After I get all her money, we will finally be together.
Really? I look forward to it. I love you, hon.
Hello? Anybody home? Excuse me, sir. Is this the home of Don Lucio Riego de Dios and Milagros Cordero?
Dinner's ready.
I have an appointment. I have a meeting with Belia. Do you know her? She's a major client.
But isn't it a bit late?
Are you doubting me?
No. It's not like that, Dagan. But,
If you like, why don't you be the one to attend the meeting with her? Better yet, why don't you leave? After all, you're the one who owns the hotel.
Dagan, go ahead. I'm sorry, I didn't...
I just received a letter from my mother. It's a few years old, but She said she used to live here. I was hoping you can tell me where to find her.
Oh, I'm sorry. They're not here. They left a long time ago.
What? Where did they move to?
Anya, are you okay?
I thought I'd forgotten everything that has happened to me. I was wrong. Until now. It's still here. I can still feel my hatred for Don Lucio. I want to see him. I want him to pay for all the things he has done to me and my family.
Mommy? What's wrong, Mom? Mommy, what happened?
Miss, can I ask you something? Do you know Presto?
Presto? That's him over there.
Presto! Presto!
Oh, okay, see ya. Miss Mira, what are you doing here?
I just wanted to check on Nathaniel. I know he's staying at your house, right?
Yeah, it's not a problem, really. Well, he's staying there for a while. Says he's just thinking things over.
Did they push through with suspending his scholarship?
Not only that, Miss Mira. They took his whole scholarship away. But Miss Mira, Nathaniel didn't really do anything to deserve that. Sam had been trying to stain his record by making trouble for the longest time now, just to strip him off his scholarship. Nathaniel has been very patient with him. But sometimes that spoiled brat is just really goes overboard. Imagine, Sam even insulted you. He said all sorts of nasty things about you. That's why Nathaniel got into that stupid fight with him. Just to defend you.
Okay.
Just leave your resume here. We'll call you to schedule your interview.
And when is that?
I said we'll just call you, okay?
Okay.
You already have evidence. Why not confront him?
I just don't have the courage. I'm scared he might leave me for good. Anya, please help me. I love Dagan very much, and I don't want to lose him. I have no one else to turn to. I don't know what to do with my life anymore. Sometimes I feel I just want to end it all. I'm a failure. I fail at being the president of the company, and I fail Dagan as a wife. I'm a failure.
Excuse me. Which way to the office of Mr. Dagon del Fuego?
It's in the second floor, ma'am.
Is he around?
He's in a meeting right now, ma'am. What's your name? I could refer you to a secretary.
No, it's okay. I'm a friend of Mr. Del Fuego. I'll just wait for him in his office. Thank you.
Who's that?
Maybe one of his mistresses.
We'll take a ride in my car. The new one. All three of you.
Sam?
If you like. Well, what do you say?
No, thank you. We'd rather eat
here. Oh, come on. I'll pay for everything. I have lots of money. You know me. Oh, how you doing, ma'am?
That's what you get for all the insults that you've said to me and my son and all those nasty things you've done.
Thank you.
Hi.
He embarrassed you.
That Casper will fall for me. Come on, I'm so good looking.
Dagan.
Anya. When did you arrive?
Just recently.
Well, what made you decide to come here, then?
Because of Trudis.
Have you seen her?
We've talked already, but I told her not to tell you yet. I didn't notify you because I wasn't sure if I was ready to come back here in the Philippines.
Well, just let me know if I can do anything for you.
Yes, Dagan. Leave your other women and be loyal to your wife.
Mira, why don't you just go and fetch your son and stop being so stubborn there?
Maybe I was never really a good mother to him. That's why he left me. Maybe I was not a good sister. Or daughter. Maybe I'm not a good person at all. That's why everyone I love has gone from me.
Stop crying, Mira. Stop blaming yourself for everything that has happened.
Hey.
Hey! How's the job hunting?
Not good. They keep telling me, thank you, they'll call me. But isn't that what they always say? If they're not interested, thanks, we'll call you. And here I am, waiting. But I know it's not gonna happen.
Jeez. Relax, dude. Take it easy.
But I'm not quitting. Even if I'm not a scholar, I will finish my studies. And I'll find a job so I can pay for my tuition.
Hey, by the way, your mother was at school today. She was looking for you. She looked like she'd been crying. Maybe she just cried or she lacked sleep. Dude, maybe you should go home already. I'm sure that would make her happy.
Mother? Good evening.
Have you eaten already? I'll prepare something for you.
Thank you, Mother.
Why does she have to tell you even our marital problems?
Because she can't tell you how she really feels. She's afraid that you might leave her. Dagan, I don't mean to meddle with your personal affairs, but as a friend, I want to save your marriage.
I don't know. Ever since, Trudis has been my problem. It's getting more and more difficult. Most of the time, her love gets suffocating. But now I realize why I married her. It's because she needs me. And not because I love her.
She's your wife now, Dagan. You already have children. If you're going to ruin your family, you might only regret it in the end. It hurts to lose a family. I should know.
Sorry.
Hi, Nicole. What took you so long? I missed you. Let's go out on a date later, okay?
You've got some nerve. You're not my boyfriend. Just because we play lovers on stage doesn't mean it can really happen.
Whoa, wait a minute. What is it that you don't like about me? I'm cute, aren't I?
You know, cute things are taken in as pets, not boyfriends.
All right, that's enough. Hello, it's time for
okay,
rehearsal.
Okay, let's go. Wait, come guys, on. Wait.
What?
Wait.
What's that?
Oops, come what's on. That?
What are you doing? We're running late.
Wow, what's that?
What is that? Where did you find that? I got it from an antique shop.
Why? Is that an amulet?
Yes.
Probably came from Japan.
Oh, I don't know. Ever since I got this, I've been having strange dreams.
Really?
Hello. What's wrong with you?
Come on.
Okay. Let's go. Coming.
Mother? I'm really sorry.
I'm sorry too, my son.
Mother, I'm sorry. You can't be proud of me anymore. I lost my scholarship.
What are you talking about? The way you fought for me? Any mother I know would be proud of that. I'm proud of you, my son.
Deny thy father and refuse thy name, or if thou will not be but sworn, my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet.
Shall I hear more, or shall I speak of this?
'Tis for thy name that is my enemy. Thou art thyself, though not a Montague. What's a Montague? It is nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man. So Romeo would, were he not Romeo, call, retain the dear perfection which he owes without that title. Hey guys, wait a minute. Where are we going to get the funds for our play?
Oh yeah, we need to look for donors and sponsors, or this play won't push through.
We need everyone's cooperation.
Sure. Well then.
All right, we have to go.
Okay.
What about you?
I'm going there.
All right.
Okay, see you later.
Bye. See you later.
Take care.
Bye. Bye.
Miss? Miss? Please don't be afraid. I'm not going to hurt you. I saw your rehearsals a while ago. You were really great. The role suits you.
Thank you.
I'm sorry. I just wanted to get your autograph.
Sure. What's your name?
Rafael.
Rafael.
And Grace, please serve dinner now. My husband's arriving early.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Trudis. I brought Anya and Terry.
Hi.
And this is for you. Where are the kids?
Upstairs.
Excuse me.
Could you believe it? He brought me flowers.
It's a shame if the play won't push through, sis. You're ready for it. And if they see you, you really look like Juliet.
You too, brother.
What?
Come on, try this on.
Okay, here. Okay. I'm sure I'm the one more suited for the role of Juliet than you are.
Let me see.
How do I look? Huh?
Brother, it looks good on you.
Really?
Timothy, why are you wearing that? Take that off.
Dad, Timothy and I were just fooling around. This is a dress I'll be using for the play.
What play?
Dad, Nicole will be a part of a play in school and...
Shut up! I'm not talking to you. Is that what you do in school? You're only wasting your time on senseless things.
Dad, it's my way of expressing myself.
And what do you need to express? Your craziness? The illusion of trying to live out a fairy tale?
But Dad...
Stop it! I don't want you to become an actress. If that's your ambition, then it's worthless. And you, huh? Toughen up! Or I'll send you to military school.
Yes.
Fix yourselves up. Your Aunt Anya is here.
Brother?
Dagon has changed. What exactly did you say to him?
I told him the truth.
Do you think he'll leave his other women?
The last time I saw you in the States, you were just a little girl. Now look at you, you're all grown up.
Thanks, Aunt Anya.
And you, Timothy, you're very handsome. How many girlfriends do you have, huh?
Oh, I'm sure he's had a lot.
My son is really very secretive when it comes to these things. He doesn't tell.
Is Timothy okay? He's been very quiet.
Because Daddy scolded him again. Dad and Timothy really don't get along. Come to think of it, none of us really get along well with Dad. And Mommy, she's always trying to please him. But he isn't aware of it. You know, Mommy's really the timid type.
And you, how are you?
I'm okay, Aunt Anya.
You know what? I think you need a break. What do you say we go out tomorrow night? Just the two of us. Is that okay with you?
Here.
Maybe you should run away from home more often.
Here.
So that your Aunt Venny would always treat us out.
Crazy kid, you're a bad influence to Nathaniel.
It was a joke.
I feel embarrassed.
Embarrassed? Why are you embarrassed? Because they deferred your scholarship? Oh, please. You know what? That's not important. What's more important is your honor. Not like those fools who took your scholarship away from you.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
Oh, my God. Let's eat. Let's eat. Hurry.
Perfect timing.
Right, looks like you're having a party. This is great.
You're just in time, all right. You'll be paying for this meal.
Wow, perfect timing.
Oh, boy!
This is great!
Look at you saying!
Oh,
I'm so good!
Wow, isn't she such a great singer?
It's your turn, Gabby! Gabby,
okay,
it's
okay,
your
my
turn.
Turn! My turn!
Your turn!
Alright,
oh,
Gabby!
You're so good, my friend! Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to dedicate this song to Mira, my love! I hope she finally comes to her senses and becomes my girlfriend!
Oh, please stop it! I told you before you won't get anything from me!
But why, Mira, babes? I'm so handsome and loyal to you! Believe me, it's true!
Because you're nothing compared to Nathaniel's father, right? Why?
Watch your mouth.
What?
I think it's your turn to sing again, Mira. Go on, just
yes,
sing.
Yes, my love, it's your turn
but
to sing.
But it's true. What I said was true.
All
fine,
right,
I'll sing.
Just sing for us.
Yes,
I'll sing. Anya.
I'm Nicole.
Anya. Whatever.
All right, it's okay. Gently now. This is your fault.
Oh,
my goodness. Over here. You take care of your mother now. I'll send your friends home, okay?
Okay. Mother. Mother. Mother.
Abel. Abel. Subalit.